locomotion is any of a variety of methods that animals use to move from one place to another. The millipede's walk is the ambulatory spectacle which we will now explore. Millipedes have more legs than any other animal. A veritable marching band of legs carry the creature through the world. What are the advantages of sporting such a plenitude of legs? On the most basic level, its numerous jointed appendages help support the long body of the millipede. Its profusion of limbs give it strength to burrow into the soil. There is curiosity as to how the legs all move together. The millipede's walk has what is called a metachronal rhythm that creates the appearance of traveling waves. It really is a remarkable feat of coordination. Members of the taxonomic phylum Arthropoda, millipedes are counted among a diverse group of invertebrate animals with exoskeletons, segmented bodies, and jointed appendages. The arthropods include all insects, arachnids, myriapods, and crustaceans. Millipedes are not insects, they are myriapods. They are the docile and diligent little street sweepers of the forest floor, spending much of their time eating decaying leaves and other dead plant matter. A helpful service, to be sure. We have slowed things down hundreds of times for the opportunity to plainly observe the millipede's mesmerizing mode of locomotion. This individual is about 8 centimeters long. It has approximately 172 legs. It is a Florida ivory millipede, or simply an ivory millipede, so named for the ivory coloration along its sides, accentuated by dark bands. Some people say the juxtaposition of light and dark on the ivory millipede reminds them of the keys of a piano, or of a backgammon board. Millipede bodies may be flattened or cylindrical like this one. The outside of the body has many overlapping segments. The very first segment after the millipede's head is called the culm, and it's like a neck or collar. The next 3 rings carry 1 leg pair each. After these, the body segments carry 2 pairs of legs. A leg on this side of the body has a mate directly on the other side, with which it shares a single set of muscles, causing them to move as one. Each of its narrow body segments is encased in 4 chitinous plates of armor, and operates 2 pairs of legs. The leg pairs walk sequentially, one after the other, from the rear to the front of the millipede's body. It must seem weird that the legs raise from back to front. People often equate front with first. In the millipede walk, front is last. Irony. To the traveling wave in the millipede's walk is that an exact amount of time passes between the lifting of one leg and the subsequent lifting of the leg in front of it. The same length of time passes between the lifting of every single leg. The regular time interval between the sequential action of the legs becomes a visible wave in the millipede's walk. It is called a metachronal rhythm, and and it is what produces the traveling wave effect in millipede legs. Metacronal rhythm is responsible for many wave-like movements in nature, such as the movement of cilia in mollusks, ciliates, comb jellies, as well as the lining of human body organs, and in large masses of some social insect species like bees. The millipede has a brain in its head and a central nervous system along the length of its body. Each of its body segments has its own mini brain called a ganglion. Inside these mini brains are clusters of neurons called central pattern generators, CPGs for short. Once walking is initiated by the main brain, the central pattern generators fire signals in regular bursts at the shared muscles of each leg pair, causing the millipede to walk. The CPGs will keep firing until they're told to do otherwise, by either the brain or sensory feedback from the legs. Millipedes basically walk on autopilot. Any signal sent from the brain will override the CPG's autopilot function. One of the advantages of the millipede being able to set itself on walk is that its brain can devote more of its limited capacity to activities that require decision-making and close attention. Activities such as acquiring food or staying out of harm's way. The constant beat of the central pattern generators compels a constant phase shift in the movement of one leg to the next, creating the appearance of a wave. It is the central pattern generators that produce the rhythmic motor movements of the millipede walk. They are generating the traveling wave. If you can train your eyes on a single leg for a while, try and notice something. The motion of the leg has two phases. First is called the power stroke, then the recovery stroke. A leg moves backwards during a power stroke while in contact with the ground. In the recovery stroke, the leg lifts up and moves forward, repositioning itself. There's something a little counterintuitive about the physics of the two stages of the walk. The stage where the most energy is being applied is the one that appears to be doing less. During the power stroke, the leg appears nearly still, with the foot clasping the ground. But much application of energy is happening in contact with the ground. On the other hand, the stage using the least amount of energy, the recovery stroke, is the more visibly active one, when the leg comes up off the ground and moves all the way up and over and down. As a leg goes through the power and recovery stages, it incrementally describes every point along the wave from crest to trough. Just as in light waves and sound waves, the highest surface part of the millipede leg wave is the crest. And the lowest part is the trough. The vertical distance between the crest and the trough is the wave height. The horizontal distance between two adjacent crests, or troughs, is known as the wavelength. Millipedes have so many legs that more than one wavelength is visible simultaneously. More to say about millipedes. I recommend you research it further. Until another time then, thanks for learning and keep being wonderful.